Well, now, KETV Newswatch 7 exclusive. Guidelines posted on a state of Nebraska website right now go against almost every recommendation to stop sudden infant death syndrome.
State health experts know it, and they're advising Nebraska child cares to ignore it. But they say at this point, they can't eliminate the bad advice. Tonight, only on 7, my iTeam investigation gets an explanation that falls short of satisfying women who know SIDS all too well.
I think I said to myself a lot too, this happened once.
Won't happen again.
It's not going to happen again.
They finish each other's sentences. Women bonded by two little boys. Two tragic stories.
The fall of 2008, I lost my second son, Brody, to SIDS.
He was placed on his belly in a bassinet at nap time.
Angie Petersen and Michelle Skillings lost their sons within weeks of each other and met at a Nebraska Sudden Infant Death Syndrome Foundation dinner.
We started talking. I sent Angie a card, and she sent me an email, and we helped each other get through our year firsts because our first Mother's Day was horrible. It was very hard. We were there for each other.
And now, as the co-directors of the foundation, they're helping others. 11 families in Nebraska last year who lost babies to SIDS, and they talked to groups about ways to prevent those deaths.
And make sure that you put your baby back to sleep in their crib, with no blankets and no bumpers and no teddy bears.
Those are the recommendations from the American Academy of Pediatrics, from the Centers for Disease Control, and from the National Institutes of Health. But check out the Nebraska Health and Human Services Manual posted on the state's website. Under regulations for child care licensing, it states center staff shall ensure each crib contains a toy such as a stuffed animal. It also states the center shall provide bumper pads for each crib in which a child under 6 months old sleeps.
To know that someone could do something wrong because the state is advising them to do it wrong and someone's child could die because the state is advising them poorly, it's frustrating, it's alarming, it's scary.
The Department of Health and Human Services declined our request for an on-camera interview, but by phone, Nebraska Chief Medical Officer Dr. Joanne Schaefer told me this is an issue she really takes to heart, that those regulations need to be changed and that they are in the process of doing that. In fact, the state of Nebraska is making numerous changes since the manual hasn't been updated since 1998. But Dr. Schaefer says there's a legal process they have to go through. One part of the manual, like the bumper rule, can't just be removed. There are differing opinions on which rules should stay and go. And all changes must get approved by the state attorney general and the governor. So for now, Nebraska will emphasize the safe sleep program in hospitals and continued education for daycare providers, trying to spread the word that these rules posted online are not current or enforced. Petersen and Skillings worry someone won't get that message in time.
Take some accountability and change it so a family doesn't bury their child because you told them wrong. It just takes once, and you don't get that second back. You'll never get it back.
There's no timetable for when new regulations will go into effect. Dr. Schaefer hopes it's by this summer. Now, we want to note the state also has a web page devoted to SIDS awareness. We've got a link to that and to the Nebraska SIDS Foundation website. Just head to KETV.com.